Paul LaFrance here, Stream of Consciousness series. Today's video is Am I a Boy or Am I a Man? And now, I talked in an earlier video about men wear more makeup than women. But this one, Am I a Boy or a Man, I'm going to take a bit of a different look at this whole boyhood versus manhood thing. So, when it comes to understanding ourselves as men, right, and women, feel free to listen. I mean, this is going to be very good. Or I'm crazy. It's one of the two. When it comes to understanding, this is happening. As men, we understand other men so often through the movies we like. Think about the movies that guys love. And I'm not just talking about the manly guys watching the shoot 'em up movies, you know, like the Die Hards or the Bravehearts or the Gladiators. Yep, there is a very distinctive element, and I know a lot of guys that just love these movies. But it's not just those movies. It's the movies like Rudy, you know, like Michael Clayton. I love tying those other movies into the movie Michael Clayton with George Clooney, where he's like a lawyer and he's just kind of lost. He's the fixer of a law firm, and at the end of the film, he has this complete, he goes on this quest, this vision quest, which was kind of started by his own son, and he makes this sacrificial decision for something that is bigger than himself, and everyone goes, fuck yeah, it's the same emotion that comes out of a movie like that, which isn't based on the guys being tough and, you know, bloodying the field at Bannockburn like you do in Braveheart, which, don't get me wrong, is one of my favorite movies of all time, but the point is, what is it about those films? There is a definitive truth that what inspires the heart of us, inside of us as men, is to be a part of something bigger than ourselves, that sacrificing your life for that purpose is worth it. That's key. That is one of the keys to us. It is in our ingrained DNA to be willing to sacrifice even our very lives for something that is more important. Because guess what? We get fucking sick of the whiny little bitch in the mirror. We really just do. Here's the flip side to this whole thing. You know, I could look back at my life and I knew every single time, no matter what justification I had, no matter how angry I was, and there are perfectly legitimate reasons for me to have been angry at stages of my life, and there were times when I was just being a little bitch. Like it was, and I don't mean bitch to be innocuous toward females. Just let that one go. Understand, this is the words we say sell us out. Every man knows when he looks in the mirror whether the words coming out of his mouth in any given situation are the words of a boy or the words of a man. It doesn't even matter how drunk you are. You're going to know. When you are arguing with your wife or your girlfriend or your partner, it doesn't matter. Whether you're having a fight with your kids, whether the guy who cut you off in traffic, we know it. It's not hard for us to know whether that part of us is coming out of that place of like calm understanding about the need to be a part of something that's greater than us, that's worth sacrificing for. Because if we're not in that life, if we're not a part of that, welcome to road rage. Welcome to the guy that just is walking around angry. If we don't have that element in our life, you know, and I'm a sports fan, don't get me wrong. Like, the Jays just missed the playoffs by a game, and I was like pissed off and heartbroken. And don't get me started on the Toronto Maple Leafs, because I don't want to start crying. But why do we love sports so much? Because we're living vicariously through a battle, you know, this need to be a part of a battle to live, and a battle to fight and an adventure to live. There's a book I read called Wild Heart that talks about this. A battle to fight, an adventure to live, and a beauty to rescue. And I love it. And the beauty to rescue is a whole other video. But I guess the question, am I a boy or am I a man? Think about all of these sayings that we have when we know. And forget what other people are saying to us. Think about what we say in the mirror. Dude, grow some balls, man. Like, put your big boy pants on. Man up. All of these statements are the statements we'll make even to ourselves in our own heads when we know that we are the furthest thing from acting like the man who knows that what he is involved with in this life is worth sacrificing his own life for something that is much greater than himself. I hope that makes sense. I'm interested in your comments. I'm not sure if I said that as clearly and concisely as I wanted to say it, but there we have it. And our next topic, we still have quite a few in here. Oh, grab two. A new perspective on ADHD in our next video.